definition of uniform continuity, some characterization and examples. Now we are going to see some nice properties of uniformly continuous function between metric spaces. So F is a function from a metric space X to a metric space Y. This function is uniformly continuous on a subset A of X. As this property is a global property, so for any epsilon greater than 0, we can find a delta given epsilon greater than 0. There exists a delta greater than 0 such that X, Y are in A with distance between X and Y is less than delta. We have rho of X and F of Y is less than epsilon. This is the definition of uniform continuity on A. So from this we can observe this function, uniformly continuous function, would carry all Cauchy sequences in A to Cauchy sequence in Y. It sends Cauchy sequences to Cauchy sequences. So this is not happening for a continuous function on metric spaces, but uniform continuity, this is happening. The proof is simple. So suppose I start with a Cauchy sequence. Suppose Xn is a Cauchy sequence in A. Cauchy sequence in A. So for any given epsilon, or a given epsilon greater than 0, so we can find an actual number, say n0, such that d of xn comma xm less than delta, sorry, less than epsilon, this is true for all n m greater than or equal to n0. From the stage n0 onwards, so all the terms of the sequence xn are close enough. So now we would like to say the image of the sequence, which is nothing but f of xn, image of the sequence, is Cauchy. So to prove that, so for the same epsilon, I need to show this rho of f of xn minus comma f of xm less than epsilon for all n and m greater than or equal n. So we are going to apply the uniform continuity of F on A, and this given sequence is Cauchy. Instead of, we want to use this relation, already the points are in xn's are in A, we would like to make this quantity like xn minus xm less than delta, then this must be less than epsilon. So we are applying the definition of Cauchiness for the sequence xn, not for epsilon, for delta, because this delta exists for the given epsilon. So now for this given delta greater than 0, we can find n naught such that xn minus xm less than delta for all nm greater than or equal to n0. So from this, if I use the equation 1, so then I have rho of, because my xn, xm are in A, and distance between xn and xm is less than delta for all n greater than or equal n0, from the relation 1 we have rho of f of xn, f of xm is less than epsilon for all n, m greater than or equal n0. So we started with any epsilon greater than 0, any epsilon greater than 0, so we could get this relation for all n, m greater than or equal n0. This proves that the image of the Cauchy sequence, again a Cauchy sequence. But this property may not hold good for continuous functions. The continuous function may send a Cauchy sequence to a non-Cauchy sequence, that we can see from an example. If we take an example, f of x is equal to 1 over x in the interval 0, 1. In the interval 0, 1. If I take the sequence 1 by n, this sequence is Cauchy because it is a convergent sequence, converges to 0. But the image of the sequence, if I calculate f of 1 over n, f of 1 over n, which is n, which is an unbounded sequence. So it cannot be a Cauchy sequence. So from this, we can say this continuous function does not carry this Cauchy sequence to a Cauchy sequence. As this function does not carry Cauchy sequence to Cauchy sequence, therefore this function cannot be uniformly continuous on 0, 1. Thus, this we have observed in the earlier example. So this function is not uniformly continuous on 0, 1. Next, here we are going to see the definition of Cauchy continuity. So we are going to observe this a function carrying Cauchy sequences to Cauchy sequence is not enough to be uniformly continuous function. So we are going to see the definition of Cauchy continuity. What do you mean by Cauchy continuity? If a function carries every Cauchy sequence in X to a Cauchy sequence in Y, then we say the function is Cauchy continuous on X. So every Cauchy continuous function is continuous. This we can observe easily. So the proof is every Cauchy sequence, Cauchy continuous function is continuous. Suppose it is not continuous. The function is not continuous on X, which means there exists a point X0 in which the continuity fails. Therefore, we will be able to find an epsilon naught which is positive, and we can construct a sequence, and there exists a point and X0, and there is a sequence in X such that distance between xn and x, x0 tends to 0. xn tends to 0, but if you calculate rho of f of xn and f of x0 is not converging, which is greater than or equal to epsilon for all n greater than or equal to n. For all in this app. Sequence yn is converging to, but x, this sequence, but what about f of xn, f of xn, f of yn, if we calculate f of yn, does not converge to f of x0, because the distance between f of xn and f of x0 is at least epsilon 1. So therefore, this sequence, f of yn, does not converge to f of x0. This proves that every Cauchy continuous function is continuous. And if we collect all Cauchy continuous functions, maybe for we can take Cauchy continuity on the entire set. Maybe if you fix a subset, then you can have this inclusion relation. So Cauchy continuous function, we have seen which is continuous. And we have seen every uniformly continuous function, every uniformly continuous function is Cauchy continuous. Every uniformly continuous function is Cauchy, every Cauchy continuous function is continuous. But you have seen example, a continuous function, not necessarily Cauchy continuous, this relation is proper. By considering the function, g of x is equal to x square on entire real life R, this function is continuous. So we have this inclusion relation, uniformly continuous function is Cauchy continuous, and Cauchy continuous is continuous. We collect all continuous functions on X, then have some collections of continuous functions, uniformly continuous functions, the collection contained in the collection of Cauchy continuous function. This inclusion relation is proper. So because we have seen the functions f of x is equal to 1 by x, f of x is equal to 1 over x, which is continuous but which is not a Cauchy continuous function. because the sequence 1 by n converges to 0, which is Cauchy, but f of xn, which is f of 1 by n, is n, is an unbounded sequence, which is not a Cauchy sequence. And if I consider the function g of x is equal to x square on R, so this is on open interval 0, 1. So this function is Cauchy continuous, one can check easily, but this function is not uniformly continuous on the entire real line. Therefore, this relation, the uniformly continuous function carries totally bounded sets to totally bounded sets. Let us see the definition of totally bounded. X be a metric space and epsilon is a positive number. A subset is said to be epsilon net for x given any x. We can choose a point y in A such that the distance between x and y is less than epsilon. So if epsilon net consisting a finitely many elements of x, then the epsilon net is called a finite epsilon net. What is the definition of totally bounded? A subset of x is said to be totally bounded if for every epsilon there exists a finite epsilon net of A. For every positive epsilon, you will be able to get a finite epsilon net for A. So there are some results. We are not going to see the proof of the results. We are going to discuss the uniform continuity on totally boundedness. Every totally bounded set is bounded, and there is a Cauchy criterion for totally boundedness which says every sequence in A contains a Cauchy subsequence, then it is a totally bounded set. It characterizes this using sequences. And every compact metric space is totally bounded. A metric space is compact if and only if it is complete and totally bounded. These are all known results in totally boundedness. The next simple proof, which says that uniformly continuous function carries totally bounded sets to totally bounded sets. So I start with the function f from x to y. Assume the function is uniformly continuous on x. Uniformly continuous on x. I start with a totally bounded set. Let S be a totally bounded subset of x. Be a totally bounded subset of x. I want to show this f of x is totally bounded. So for that, I need to start with a sequence in f of s. I take a sequence yn in f of s. So I should be able to find a subsequence of yn which is Cauchy. So as this yn's, the entries of the sequence are in f of s, then we will be able to get an xn in s such that f of xn is yn. F of xn is y. There could be many, so this function not necessarily one, there could be many, but for each yn at least we will be able to get an xn. So now this sequence xn in S is a sequence in S. So as S is totally bounded, so this sequence has a Cauchy subsequence, say xnm, index is varying for m. This is a Cauchy subsequence of xn because S is totally bounded. So as this is a Cauchy sequence, as this function f is uniformly continuous on entire x, then this function takes Cauchy sequence to Cauchy sequence. So we have observed in the last result. So f of xn is a Cauchy subsequence. So I find the image of f of xnm, which is the image of this subsequence of xn. So therefore this sequence, varying index is varying over m to infinity. So this is a subsequence of yn. This sequence is a subsequence of yn. But uniform continuity says this sequence is Cauchy and this Cauchy sequence goes to Cauchy, therefore this is Cauchy, therefore the sequence yn, what we started with in f of x, has a subsequence which is Cauchy. This proves that f of s is totally bounded by the Cauchy criterion for totally boundedness. Next, we are going to see some examples. So, the continuous functions may not carry totally bounded sets to totally bounded sets. Because we take the same example, the function g of x is equal to 1 over x in the interval 1 by 0 to 1. 0 to 1. You take this function is defined on a bounded set. And this, because in the set of real numbers we know totally boundedness and boundedness are same, because we have taken the usual metric. So in this case, this totally bounded, this set is totally bounded. But what's its image? The image of the set is I include 0 to 1, including 1. So the image of the set is 1 to infinity, which is unbounded. This set cannot be a totally bounded set. Therefore, this is an example of a continuous function defined on open 0, closed 1, which does not carry totally bounded sets to totally bounded set. But this uniformly continuous function carries totally bounded sets to totally bounded sets. And one can easily prove this using this characterization, tan x, a tangent function tan x on the interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 is not uniformly continuous. Because this function is bounded, the image of this entire set is minus infinity to infinity, which is unbounded. Therefore, this tangent function cannot be uniformly bounded on this interval. And the property of continuous function from a matrix, compact matrix space to a compact matrix space, so its range is also compact. So continuity is enough. Continuity sends compact sets to compact sets. The same thing is true for a uniformly continuous function, because every uniformly continuous function is continuous. And if you have a uniformly continuous function on x, then the function maps every compact subset to a compact subset of y. So we have seen uniformly continuous functions carry totally bounded sets, Cauchy sequence, and compact sets to the same set of sets. So now the question comes, do any or all of the above three properties characterize uniform continuity? So the answer is no. So there is an example. If you take an exponential function, so the exponential function satisfies the first property, because all Cauchy sequences are convergent R. It sends convergent sequences to convergent sequence that are convergent, therefore they Cauchy. Therefore it sends Cauchy sequences to Cauchy sequences. It also satisfies the second property, because being continuous function on entire real line R, it is uniformly continuous on every bounded subset. Because we have seen, if a function is continuous on a compact set, it must be uniformly continuous. So if you take a bounded set, you take its closure, then it becomes a compact set, because in the real line, the compact sets are precisely closed and bounded sets. Therefore, it satisfies the second property. It also satisfies the third property, because it sends bounded sets to bounded sets, because the total boundedness and boundedness are same. Therefore, if you have a function has these three nice properties, then there is no guarantee that the function would be uniformly continuous. So exponential function on the entire real line is not uniformly continuous, but this exponential function has these three nice properties. So what about in the set of all the intervals, if you take the real values Rn, so there also boundedness and totally boundedness are same. Therefore, we can say the same thing is true for a metric space Rn with the Euclidean metric. But we have seen this boundedness and totally boundedness are totally different. So if you take the identity function, which is uniformly continuous on as the set of natural numbers, because the domain is a discrete metric, but if you find its range, so range is range on the domain we have taken the discrete metric, on the codomain we have taken a usual metric. Therefore, in the domain it is bounded, so therefore in codomain it is unbounded. Therefore, it is not taking bounded set to bounded set. Now the question comes, whether uniformly continuous function carries bounded sets to bounded sets. So in general it is not. So this is an example. So uniformly continuous function may not carry bounded sets to bounded sets. That we have observed from this example. So there is an interesting characterization for total boundedness using the contour set and the uniform continuity. So we know contour set, if you take any subset of a contour set which is totally bounded, which is bounded, and every uniformly continuous image of a subset of a contour set is totally bounded, therefore it sends uniformly continuous function sends totally bounded sets to bounded sets. So what happens for any totally bounded set on a metric space? So suppose if you are having a metric space which is totally bounded, using this Cantor set in uniformly continuity, can we characterize it? Yes, we can characterize. If you start with any non-empty metric space, this space is totally bounded, if and only if there exists a bijective uniformly continuous function from the Cantor set K onto the Cantor set the space X. So if you are able to get a bijective uniformly continuous function from K onto X, then this metric space must be totally bounded. And this result also says all totally bounded metric spaces are relatively small. So I am not giving the proof of this. If you are interested, you can find this proof in some textbooks. Now, if you have a continuous function which is defined on some subset of a metric space, so F is a function from X to Y, and this F is continuous on A, which is a subset of X. The question comes, can we extend this continuous function to a whole space, capital X? So what do you mean by extension? So if you are extending a function, suppose G is an extension of F, if, so then on domain of G both are same. F and G are same on domain of F. And the domain of G is bigger than domain of F. Then we say G is an extension of F. There could be several extensions for the functions. And in other words, we can say F is a restriction of G on domain of F. So for a given F, if you are able to find an extension, and if this extension happens to be a continuous function, if you start with the continuity of F, then G is said to be a continuous extension of F. So there is an example. If you take F of X is X sine 1 by X, the function is defined over the interval 0 to pi, 1 over pi, which is not defined at 0, but if you consider the new function G, which is taken to be 0 for x0, then this is an extension. And moreover, you can check easily from the graph of G, this G is a continuous extension of F. But whereas if you take the function f of x sin x, already we have seen the graph of sin x, near 0 the function oscillates rapidly. between minus 1 and 1. So this function cannot be extended to a bigger domain. If you are able to do extend the, but extended function not necessarily will not be a continuous function. So extension simply we can define at a point 0, but whether such extension is continuous or not, in this case it is not possible. So this is a graph of the function f of x is x sine 1 by x, which is defined over the interval 0 to 1 over pi. You can see are near when x is converges when x goes near to 0, then this fx goes to 0.